up, it's Taka here. Welcome back to my weekly blog. So I've been working on refactoring the core modules of the desktop app, and the upcoming version will have a new Markdown processor and renderer that is built with the latest version of Remark. And so the current version uses the older version of Remark, which is a Markdown processor that supports plugins. And it is very popular in the JavaScript community. And it's very versatile, so you can extend the processor using the plugins like this. It's very simple to use, and I wanted to update this module to the latest version. I couldn't do that because there are a bunch of breaking changes, so the existing Inkjet plugins will not work properly. So, but the latest version comes with a bunch of improvements, like the latest version of Remark is now built with MicroMark, which is another Markdown parser engine that can be extended with plugins like so. And as you can see, there are a lot of useful extensions, and also there are many plugins for Remark that uses the latest version of MicroMark. So I wanted to upgrade it. And so this means that some existing plugins may not work properly. So I will be working on updating them. So I'll be helping plugin developers update their community plugins. And I've been working on improving the rendering engine. So one of the improvements is the performance. GitHub supports Mermaid and Mass syntax by default. So I wanted to support those syntaxes. I wanted to support them out of the box. But Mermaid and Mass requires a huge libraries, so loading those plugins affects the launch speed. So I decided to use React.lazy to asynchronously load those libraries when necessary. By doing that, the plugins are loaded the editing node uses one of these syntaxes. For example, so here is the development version. And I'm gonna reload it. So this node doesn't use math or Mermaid, so the plugins are not loaded yet. And when you open node that uses math, it loads the plugin. So let's open the node that uses Mermaid. So as you can see, it rendered asynchronously. It rendered a Mermaid diagrams asynchronously. Yes. But the second time, it renders immediately because the plugin is already loaded. Well, let's try again. Yes, so you can ignore this a lot. So this improves the launch speed significantly. Even if you use Mermaid and Mac. And the next improvement is giving an easy way to access to MDAST. So I've refactored I've been refactoring the rendering engine, and I found that it would be nice to expose the parsed Markdown data to the plugin developers, to the users, because sometimes you want to extract some parts of data, some parts of the editing notes, like YAML font matter or number of tasks, like headings. It was hard to do that because you have to use write regular expressions to extract those data. But the next version will provide a way to access the parsed Markdown data. So MDAST stands for Markdown Abstract Syntax Tree, which means that you can access state value MDAST here. So as you can see, you can get a structured abstract syntax tree here. And I'm currently opening this node, and it has a mass code block. So as you can see, it has a mass code block here, and you can get a value here. So you can get you can quickly get extract some parts from the node without using any regular expressions. That would be nice. For example, if you wanna get headings, you can simply use visit utility function to get every heading here, like this. So which is very handy. So it will be also useful even if you don't have it will be also nice for users who are not developing plugins, because you can use this MDAST data to automate some tasks, like converting task lists, things like that. So yeah, that'd be nice. So the next one is an issue that the plugins can't import EES modules. So for some reason, Electron process crashes when you try to import EES modules in your plugins like this. So the plugins are basically CommonJS. And CommonJS can load ES modules by using a dynamic import. So importing ES modules is now important because the new MicroMark modules and WeMark are on the ES modules. But you can't import Unified, yeah, it goes zero. So you can't even require those modules, like so. So it has a cannot mark pass. So yeah, because this module is ES module. As you can see, type. Yes, type is wrong. So you can't require ES modules by calling require. And also, You can't. You can't do that. That is hard. And also, if you try to call a dynamic import from the plugin, the renderer process always crashes for some reason. So it is hard to support it. So that is not correct. It's working. Yes. And also, crashes. So the app can't dynamically import. And also, the app crashes if you import ES modules by calling a dynamic port. So currently, I have to bundle the ES modules by using Rollup in my plugins. And I found that VS Code is also suffering from this issue. And so I don't know how to solve that at the moment. So if you know any workaround, please let me know in the comments down below. Yes, so that's it for this week. Thank you for watching, and hopefully I'll be able to publish a first beta version next month. So I'm looking forward to its release. So thank you for watching and have a productive day.